Good morning, friends. Peace be with you. I'm so glad that you're here today with me. We've been talking all month long about blessing. Last week, we talked about how Jacob had a special dream, and in his dream, God came and spoke to him. God said that he would bless him. He would be with him always, would never leave him. This week, we hear about an even bigger dream. This is one of God's dreams. But before we hear today's story and we learn about God's big dream, let's sing our opening song together. This month, during Advent, I would like to sing our song that we've been learning. You learned maybe last year with me, and if you've been in choir with Miss Marcia, you've been hearing this song too. It's called Come Light Our Hearts. We say, for you, O Lord, our souls in stillness wait. And then it repeats, for you, O Lord, our souls in stillness wait. And then we say, truly our hope is in you. Truly our hope is in you. Can we try that together? Here we go. For you, O Lord, our souls in stillness wait. For you, O Lord, our souls in stillness wait. Truly our hope is in you. Truly our hope is in you. Truly our hope is in you. Very good. We'll sing that song every week during our season of Advent this year. We've been in the book of Genesis, hearing about Abraham and his family, Isaac and Rebekah, and how they had their children, Jacob and Esau. Remember last week, Jacob had his dream of the ladder. This week, we're going to be in the book of Isaiah. Isaiah is almost towards the middle of the Bible. So if I open up my Bible here, you can see we're almost in the middle. Today's story is about God's dream. So let's hear now what God's big dream is for his creation and for the world and for each of us. Let's read.
A long time ago, God sent a message to the prophet Isaiah to share with the people. The message said that a little child would come and teach us how to live in peace. When there is peace, a wolf can live with a lamb. When there is peace, a leopard can lie down with a goat. When there is peace, a cow and a lion can share their food without fighting. When there is peace, young cows and young bears will be friends and play together. When there is peace, a child will lead us.
Was God's big dream? That the world would be filled with peace. And what happens in this dream? We hear the wolf will lie with who? A lamb. And the leopard will lie down with a goat. The calf and the lion will feed together. And the little child will lead them. Can that happen in real life right now? Can a child lead a lion or the wolf lie with a lamb? No, not right now. But this is God's dream. And in God's dream, everything is full of peace. Everyone lives together in harmony. Every animal would be able to live in peace. All of God's people would live together in peace. That is God's biggest dream. And we, as Christians, as people that follow God, who love God, we want to try to do those things. We want to try to live in peace, to live in harmony with our brothers and our sisters, with our friends and our family. For those people that look like you and those people that don't look like you, God calls us to live in peace with them and in harmony. I wonder what it might be like to lie down with a wild animal, like a lion or a tiger, a cheetah or a leopard. I wonder what that might be like. I know right now I would be very scared if I had to lie down with a lion. But I can only imagine how wonderful it would be in this world of peace. And if everything was in peace and harmony, I bet being beside a lion would be really nice. Be nice and warm and cozy. What do you think? I wonder what's in our wonder basket today. You have any ideas? What are these? Peace signs, yes. You may have seen this sign before, or like this. And it's holding up the number 2, yes, but it's also the sign of peace. We also know that peace is like this, and it starts with praying hands, and it spreads out. Peace is that reminder. I love that sign language, that symbol, because it's coming together with our praying hands and then spreading it out. Spreading out that peace for others. This story reminds us God's biggest dream is the peace for everyone. And I pray that during this Advent season, I pray that today, I pray that always you seek to find that peace that God gives, and then share that peace with the world. Let's say a prayer together and thank God for the gift of peace. Let's pray. 5 here, 5 there. Put them together and let's say a prayer. Dear God, we thank you for this dream, for this beautiful image of the wolf flying with the lamb, the child leading the lion, for a world of peace. Help us to find that peace and to share it with others so that our world can live in harmony. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, friends, let's sing our goodbye song.
Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go.
Have a great day. See you next time.